Hello. Today, I am going to demonstrate how to use your Google account to download and install Cisco Anyconnect and how to use Anyconnect to VPN into the school network. This shows using a laptop in the process. First, we have to determine if Anyconnect is already installed. Since it's Cisco Anyconnect, typically this would be in your desktop under C for Cisco, but we don't see Cisco here. No Cisco, let alone Anyconnect. Anyconnect might be here on your start, but in this case, it's not in our start. It might be on our desktop, but in this case, it's not on our desktop and it's not in our system tray. Okay, so we've tried to look for Anyconnect. We don't have Anyconnect. We can also look here to see, is it anywhere on our machine? We see where we've maybe hit it a few times from the browser, but it's not currently on our machine. So we're going to install Anyconnect. We're going to bring up Chrome because that's what we typically use. And your firewall name would be different than ours. Our firewall name is gaps.k12.nc.us. Your IT person should have given you the name of your firewall. So we're going to bring up our firewall. Your little icon would look a little different. This is our school mascot here. And your IT person should have given you the name of the pull down you're supposed to use. Yours might be teacher, it might be staff, whatever. Ours is heating and air conditioning or HVAC. You can see where that's not the default here, but we're going to choose it. We're going to hit the login button. Now on our next screen, if you've never logged into Google, you would have to log into Google. It might be you're already logged into Google though, in which case you wouldn't have to re-log in. In our case, we've signed out of Google, but we're going to hit the button to sign in. Our password's stored here. And at this point, our browser is talking to Google. Google's talking to the firewall. The firewall is talking to us. It basically worked. And we might or might not see a continue button here. It depends on how your firewall is configured. Okay, we're going to hit the continue button. And since we want to download Anyconnect, we're going to choose Anyconnect here. And we're going to choose start Anyconnect, which actually allows us to download Anyconnect when we go down here. We're going to download it for Windows. Now, sometimes people will have antivirus installed on their laptop or something that prevents them from installing executables. Hopefully you don't. If you do, you'll need to talk to your IT person about that. We're just going to hit the Anyconnect executable, hit the next button here. We're going to accept the terms of the license agreement and install. Usually a pretty quick install here. All right, and it worked. Okay, I'm going to kill the browser just so we can see a little bit better here. And now when we go to our start menu, we see Cisco is there with Anyconnect under there. We also see where an icon has been created here. Okay, so we're going to click on the icon to actually use Anyconnect. Now ours has pre-populated the name of the firewall here. If yours hasn't, you would just need to screen scrape this and put this over here. Okay, now again, we get into the status of the laptop. Hopefully, since you've just logged into Google and haven't logged out, there's still a cookie stored in your laptop. So we're going to hit the connect button. And you briefly saw the different pull downs flash there, but there's a cookie stored, so it should know that you're a heating and air conditioning person. Again, our Google magically came up. I'm going to hit our continue here. Okay, you successfully authenticated. And we again see our continue button. Sometimes you might see this depending on how the firewall is configured. Okay. Anyconnect is finishing doing its thing here. At this point, if we decided to do something else, we can disconnect, but we should be able to access our internal resources that we need to get to inside the school. Now, if we can't access our internal resources, we need to have a look at the routes. So we hit the gear button here. We go over to the route details. And you see how we have routes to two different machines, two different IP addresses inside the network. Hopefully, that's all we need to get to. If we need to access more machines inside the network, but we don't see routes to them, this is a firewall configuration issue. So you would need to talk to your IT department about this, but they would need a screenshot of this to work on troubleshooting the problem. Okay, and that's about it.